today we're gonna talk about installment. Okay. So for example, you're gonna buy a house one day, and with your salary, you cannot pay everything cash. So you have to
loan.
Okay. So let's say this is the house. Let's see. So small. That's why the price is only
700k.
500k. Maybe this is very far away, lah. Very far away in a small house, and maybe it's a bit haunted, so like this. Okay, 500,000. Okay. Now, as a fresh grad, how much do you think is salary?
2,000 to 3,000.
If you are a uni grad, if college, maybe slightly lower, and it depends. So let's say if you go to an executive job, maybe it's around that 2,000, maybe from 2,000. If you're from medical line, it's usually around 3,000 to 4,000. Yeah, but 3,000 now. So now with that amount of money, let's say you just start saving for 1 year, 2 years, 3 years.
500 divided by 3.
Then you feel like you want to buy a house already.
It takes 1 year.
Okay? Do you think you can pay cash?
No.
So you have to
take a 10-year loan.
So let's say she is the one who sell the house. I want to buy this house.
Then you tell.
Then she asks me, hey, can you pay 500,000 cash? Of course you say cannot. Is there any other option?
Why?
Then she will say, don't worry.
Loan.
You just need to pay down payment first. Down payment. You know what's down
booking
payment
fee,
is?
Buy fee. Like pay a percentage
booking
of the
first, but down payment is the one that's settled it.
So
your down payment is maybe they say around 10%. So you just need to pay me the down payment 10% of this amount, and the rest you can stay in the house already, and the rest you can pay slowly over 20 years or 30 years, something like that. Yeah. So now let's say the down payment is 10%. How much is this 10%?
50,000.
10% times 500,000, you get 50. So this 50,000, you have to pay up front. Meaning you have to pay
right
first. Yeah. Right. Fresh, yes. So now, okay, in total this is 50,000. And then I can stay in the house already. Even though I still have my outstanding balance. What is my outstanding balance?
400,000.
Yes. Outstanding balance is your leftover. 500k, I take away.
50k.
So my outstanding balance is 450,000. This one is the one that I need to pay slowly. Okay. Let's say then after that I go to Junhan. Junhan is a banker. I shouldn't tell you. If you don't have the amount of money, of course you go to
bank
tomorrow, right? So then ask Mr. Junhan, I would like to borrow this 450,000. Then he said, of course, sure. But as a banker, do you think he just let you lend this for 20 years or 30 years?
No.
He will
minimum.
He will charge you interest. So then Junhan said, okay, but I'm gonna give you interest 2%
per year.
So cheap per annum, okay, per year. Interest 2% per annum, and you can pay slowly for
10 years.
Not bad, right? Actually
so,
very cheap.
So
okay. So let's say if I calculate simple interest formula is PRT over 100. So let's calculate. Now, how much is the money I want to borrow for the bank?
45,000.
Yes, I'm going to borrow this, I'm not going to borrow that. Because I already pay 50k. So I just need to borrow 450k. Get me?
Wow.
My rate is 2% for 20 years. Help me calculate.
How much is the interest?
4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. So you need to pay
9,000 per year.
You borrowed this from the bank, right? For the 50,000, so that I settle with her. She's the one who is gonna. Okay, so yeah, so I pay her 50k down payment, and then I borrow from Junhan 450, pay her, finish. But with Junhan, I still need to pay him back 450,000 and.
Oh, interest.
180k. Yes, of course we have to pay more. Right? So now,
so banker, don't do what?
You can straight pay everything, then the interest stops, right? And then you just pay
all interest,
right? Yeah, but you already signed a contract how many years?
But no, can you do that though? Like suddenly you get the money, then you just pay. You know?
I think once you sign the contract, that's the agreement already. Yeah.
You win the lottery, signing $20 million.
Already signed contract.
So basically, if I sign the contract, right, what if I just pay 400,000, adding 180,000?
Okay.
So I sign contract for 20 years, right?
Yes.
Okay. So the interest, 180,000.
Okay.
So plus 400,000. Can I just pay straight? Right?
Okay. You can, but for what? People give you slowly.
No, if I win the lottery,
it'll still be the same. If I win the lottery, rather than. Because I already signed 20 years, I might as well just pay them slowly and I use the money to turn my money somewhere else. You understand?
Good.
Rather than I just pay for what I already agreed.
Then you go and get interest.
Okay? So what do you think is my monthly installment? Oh wait, not monthly installment first. What is the total amount of money I have to pay Junhan? This is what we call as higher purchase. So I need to pay Junhan
480,000
plus 680,000, which is 630,000. So this amount of money I'm
gonna
pay slowly over
20
years. So what is my monthly installment?
I'd rather live in a house for like 18 years and then buy a house in cash 500k.
Monthly, 20 years is how many months?
240.
One year is
2625.
So meaning for 20 years, you're gonna pay Junhan 2,625
per month.
So let's say you earn around
2,000.
Because this is almost 3 already.
Yeah. I thought it depends on your salary.
Yeah,
also.
Yeah, that's what I told you.
I thought when they were left money from the bank, right? I thought they'll check your salary as well.
Yeah.
Yes, they will need to check your salary. Your salary is like that.
Too low, then
they'll not.
Normally, would it be like, have to be double the amount you're paying?
It depends. It's not just because of that. They will need to check your credit card record. If you're a type of person who swipe, you don't pay, they will not lend you this big money. So you need to have a clean record. Alright, so anyway, let's compare. If I pay cash, I use
only 500,000.
If I use with higher
purchase,
680,000.
No, 680,000 plus 50,000.
Correct.
So 680,000.
If I use higher purchase.
So what is higher purchase?
Higher purchase meaning installment.
You pay a lot more.
Yes.
680,000.
I need to pay my down payment first, correct?
Yes.
Plus
630,000.
Which is
680,000.
Okay.